Hi guys, welcome back to our drone channel. Today with a very, very short term video, as we have received a new firmware update for either the DJI RC controller and the DJI RC2 controller. What this update brings to you and what you can expect, I'm gonna show you in this video, so stay tuned. If you like what you see, then subscribe. This latest firmware update specifically targets the DJI Fly app, not the drones themselves. However, since the in-house app is available in all remote controllers, you may need to perform multiple updates. The DJI RC2 update is identified as V02000500, and for the RC it is labeled V01031200. The description provides promising and valuable enhancements. But that's not all. DJI has evidently assembled a team of UX experts and started revising the user interface. Additionally, the QuickTransfer feature has been significantly made more pragmatic and placed more straightforwardly. So you can definitely look forward to it. After completing the update, which takes approximately 20 minutes, a welcome screen appears, introducing us to the new features. Well, the first notable addition is the Before You Fly button, providing guidance on where we can fly and essential drone-related information. In the Academy, a familiar feature, users can learn about aircraft control. The connection guide, also not entirely new, assists in establishing a connection with the drone. Alright, let's acknowledge these features and delve into the details. Clicking the Before You Fly button opens a disclaimer clarifying that the information is sourced from other users and DJI holds no responsibility for it. Well, a standard disclosure. Well, in the background, a faint map is visible with a foreground window. Here the users select their region of interest, such as Europe. A cascade menu appears allowing users to choose specific regions. For instance, I select Germany and then navigating to Hannover places the user on the map. A new guide opens specifically for Germany, emphasizing the importance of checking local regulations first. Tapping on specific location provides additional information. Notably, users can create and share locations using the plus symbol, introducing an engaging feature for networking. We're gonna see this later on in detail. Alright, zooming out reveals a map dotted with numerous orange areas representing no-fly zones. Additionally, spots from other pilots marked by quick picture uploads are visible. So let's explore one of these spots, like the Burgbergturm, in English Castle Hill Tower. Well, it opens specific details including region, picture, control assessment, well, that's pretty interesting, address, security and reviews. User can add spots to their favorites or contribute their ratings. Clicking on one of these pictures reveals an aerial shot with details provided by this user called Drone Pilot. Very creative. The option to follow users adds an intriguing social aspect. Oops, what's this? Looks like a bug, huh? Every time I want to do something, the annoying region window opens. Well, that's strange. Who else has this bug? Just write it in the comments. I think DJI needs to improve this. Alright, let's look for a no-fly zone and select one. What happens here? A window opens and asks me what I want to fly with. Okay, let's choose the model. Oh cool, we find a list of all DJI models. This is the subcategory of mini models. Let's jump to the Mavic models and select the Mavic 3 Pro. Well, this changes the get prepared section because for the large drones in Germany, we also need a proof of competence. Clicking on it takes me to a new menu, quite nested everything. Alright, operator registration with the Federal Aviation Office. The More button takes me to the registration and then directly to the Federal Aviation Office page. The label aircraft shows me information on how to attach the registration number to the drone. Okay, that's nice. And proof of competence provides all the necessary information for the test to be completed. Aha, definitely helpful. All right, back then to the Mini 4 Pro. I'm done with everything. What now? Okay, interesting. Precautions shows me what kind of area it is. Namely, a geozone. All right, we also see the known interferences that could disrupt flying. In this case, none. All right, let's jump to Spain, Seville, and create a new location near, guess what? Carmona, using the create new fly spot button. A new window opens. Ah, okay, here comes the topic of the privacy disclaimer again. The data is user generated and has nothing to do with DJI. Okay, let's check that. We can enter the name. Makes sense. Well, enter test. Okay, I know it's flat. Okay, clicking the blue arrow. Okay, keyboard doesn't close. Another bug? Well, that's a bit annoying. Fine, I'll tap the add topic button. Maybe this helps. Ah, okay, now it disappears. Great, of course, this is an outstanding spot rated with at least 5 stars. Then select beginner friendly. Well, that's pretty easy and intuitive. And upload another picture. Well, okay, I don't have a suitable one right now, but the function is pretty simple. And submit. Not working. Ah, okay, it wants a short description from me. Well, let's leave that out for now. I think we've understood how it works well enough. Okay, jumping back to the main menu. Now there is the quick transfer button. Tapping it takes us to the information screen that explains us how to use quick transfer quickly and easily. Well, quick transfer is designed to easily and conveniently transfer pictures from the drone directly to the phone without using the remote control or a computer in between. Well, additionally, you don't need to remove the micro SD card from the drone. To do this, simply open the DJI Fly app on your phone and connect the drone. To connect, just tap on the Enable Quick Transfer Mode button. Well, it's as simple as that. This takes a short moment. Afterwards, we automatically jump to the drone's album and can now select our files. On the other side, the remote control shows us that quick transfer mode is active and another device is connected. Once we found what we were looking for, simply click on the small arrow in the bottom right and the image or video will be downloaded. As soon as we are done, click on exit quick transfer mode on the remote control and regain control of the drone. Well, simple, isn't it? All right, let's take a look at the service button. Primarily, we see 6 possible options. Under service request, we can create a repair request. Under DJI Care Express, we can order replacement products. Well, however, it's not available in all countries. Under fly away service, guess what? We can report a loss, like your drone has flown away. Okay. Under service progress, we see our current and past service requests and their status. Under CX label request, we can request a label for a C-classified drone to attach it to the drone. And under more services, we find all other inquiries to DJI. Okay, now let's take a look at the display zoom. From now on, we can influence the font size on the flight screen, which could be very helpful, especially for people with visual impairments. We can now choose between the familiar standard font size and a larger font size. For testing purpose, let's select the larger font size. And as you can see well on the bottom of the screen, the font size is noticeably larger and more readable. If you want to change this later, just click on the menu, the 3 dots in the upper right corner, and select the control tab. The second menu item is display zoom. Tap here and you can set it back to standard to return to the familiar font size. Lastly, the search field on the home screen. Here we can enter buzzwords or keywords to get specific and relevant search results. Let's test it by searching for altitude. 4 results are provided, 2 of which are videos that we can watch on the topic. Let's choose mini 2 tips and tricks for testing, and I'm pretty curious. And the video is displayed with Otto. Who don't know Otto? Well, he's explaining something. Okay, anyway, I recommend playing a bit around with this and see how helpful it really is.
Home point updated. Takeoff.
And that's it for today. Hope you were able to take something out of it. What do you think about the new features? Useful or unnecessary? Let's talk about in the comments. If you liked the video, smash that like button and sub to the channel. Gonna catch you in the next video upcoming. Be curious. Life's too short to be angry. Have a nice day. See you soon. Bye bye.